certified in orthokinetics, biomechanics of resistance training, and muscle activation technique. He's also a licensed massage therapist and holds belts in 3 different martial arts systems and was a wildland firefighter. Elizabeth Albert is the owner of Tread Fitness here in Dallas, Texas. She received her bachelor's degree in psychology from the University of Texas at Arlington, where she also played Division I college basketball. She is also a certified personal fitness trainer, a group fitness instructor, a certified fitness nutrition coach, and has been a basketball trainer for 10 years. And of course, Dr. Tim Church is a medical doctor, also a master of public health, a PhD, and one of the country's leading physicians in exercise and obesity research. Okay, last week, Daniel, we were talking about squats versus deadlifts. So let's talk about the difference between the two first and kind of recap, if you will.
The biggest difference is a lot of it's the same movement pattern. You can modify both. The biggest is where you're picking it up from, whether it be a straight bar doing deadlifts or a hex bar doing deadlifts, which is kind of one that kind of surrounds you. You step inside of it and you pick it up, or a barbell, which you usually put on your back and do squats that way. It's all a squat movement, and we've defined it as a squat and a deadlift, but it's really the same movement, and you can vary both of them differently. It's the loads that change.
Well, and it is it's so important because your lower body really, what do I want to say here? It's like the foundation, if you will, right, of like a tall building, literally. And so I'm going to ask you, Elizabeth, about deadlifts and squats. Which do you prefer?
I love deadlifts.
You like I love deadlifts, too.
I feel like the deadlift, it gets you a bigger, butt.
A bigger butt?
Bigger butt. For women.
Isn't that funny? Women used to want their butts small. Now they want their butts big. I'll never figure it out. But I guess a healthy butt is what you want, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. And Dr. Church, I'm going to ask you this. Which powerful move is the king of all exercises, deadlifts or squats? Because you are truly the expert here.
No, I'm not. I mean, these guys do this every day. I fly at this 30,000 foot level. I would do whatever my personal trainer would tell me to do. I think there's an important point here. With aerobic, it's pretty easy to figure out. Anybody can just kind of go to the mall and walk. I like to tell people when it comes to resistance training, you really do need to find a professional to get you hooked up.
Yeah.
You know, you can't just go out and kind of fake this stuff. I'm one of the world's leading experts on exercise and weight loss, and I have a personal trainer because I can't keep up with this stuff.
Mm-hmm. So does your trainer have you do both deadlifts and squats?
I mean, they'll mix it up.
Mix it up?
Yeah. I mean, that's one of the main reasons I use – I shouldn't say that. I've been training so much jiu-jitsu, I haven't been using my trainer enough. Anyway, when I do, they mix it up.
Okay. And so, Daniel, you know, what are the pros and cons of each?
You know, the con against the barbell on your back would be if you're not doing it right, it could potentially damage your neck, because if people are leaning forward a little too much and it goes up on their neck, that could potentially be harmful. The doing deadlifts, if you don't have the hip mobility or the hip motion or knee motion or ankle motion to get the bar at the bottom, you're going to start in a preloaded position for the lower back and can really hurt the lower back. You see films on YouTube all the time of people doing deadlift maxes, and their lower back is just really curved under, which means you're loading that lower spine, and it's really not a good thing for the lower spine to be loaded in that way.
Yeah.
So that would be a potential risk there. You could just kind of brace it up a little bit to where you can lean down and get it without bending your lower back, or hopefully you have the mobility to get down there and do it. But those are some of the bigger pros and cons, or at least cons.
Okay, so Elizabeth, you said you prefer the deadlift over the squat, and why is that, and how do you do yours?
Well, I like to do deadlifts more, but I like Dr. Church was saying, I like to change it up a little bit. I like to work every part of the muscle group. I think that with deadlifts, you know, slight bend in the knees, especially if it's a heavy load, just for safety. But again, going back to what Daniel was saying last week, depending on your body, depending on the load, you know, you sometimes don't have to bend your knees, you know, so.
Well, it comes down to what Dr. Church said. It's like, it's just like in physiology and the studies that he was doing, it's a case by case, you know, thing. And the same thing with body by body, who has the range of motion. The way that Elizabeth is doing deadlifts is more like a straight legged or, you know, just a lock legs deadlift, right? So you can also bend your knees in that and go more knees and get more quads in it too. So there's different types of motions you can do with it. The way that she's doing it is going to really isolate the glutes. If you bend down with a little bit more knee motion, then it becomes more like a narrow or wide squat, depending on what your motion at the knees is.
And you can go heavier on the weight with that slight bend.
Oh, yes.
Nice. Okay, so let's talk about muscle activation. Mm-hmm. For people that don't know, what is it?
So it's making sure the muscle sends the signal to the brain. The brain sends the signal back to the muscle to get it to fire. It's called alpha-gamma coactivation. And the
sounds complicated.
It is. It goes more on the neurological side, which is not my forte. I deal with more biomechanics. I know a little bit about the neurological side, just enough to make me dangerous. But the big thing is there's three systems in the body. You have the skeletal system, which is the framework, the muscles, which move the framework. But the neurological system is the link from the brain to the muscle to tell the muscle to contract, therefore moving the bones. So if you don't have a strong connection, then that muscle is not going to contract. So you could have the strongest muscle in the world, but if you can't contract it, it means absolutely nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of what activating the muscle is make sure first you need to do basically applied kinesiology testing, muscle testing, and try to single out a muscle as best you can. There's always going to be multiple muscles firing, but you test these things to see, is this muscle really going to sustain under force in a neurologically weak position, which would be a shorter position? And then if it's not, then you're saying, hey, we need to target this by some specific exercise or by some treatment,
mm-hmm.
and then put it back into the movement pattern like the deadlift or the squat. Because if certain muscles, like if the glutes aren't firing, you can be set up in a great biomechanical way to get those glutes to fire with those lifts.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not going to fire because they're not creating that signal. So, you know, hamstrings are going to take over. Some spinal extensors might have to take over. So you need to go back in and be able to test those in a somewhat scientific way to where you can say, hey, is this muscle really doing what I need it to do? Because if the right glute's firing and the left glute's not, then that left glute's going to take over.
Mm-hmm.
And you work on imbalances. The strong things get stronger. The weak things get weaker. And that can cause injury when we're doing more intense exercise like jiu-jitsu. If you're trying to do something like that,
mm-hmm.
certain muscles aren't firing. You're going to do the movement and you're going to make it work.
Right.
But you might be in a vulnerable position to pull something or damage a joint or something else if everything's not working optimally.
Well, and you can find so many different ways to exercise. You know, we talk about accessibility.
Mm-hmm.
There's some great exercises that never make the top five list because they're either performed on a very niche machine or not everyone can perform them. For example, like it's highly unlikely a one-handed pull-up is going to make it to the top five list of best exercises because it takes a long time to work up to a one-handed
That's
pull-up.
That's so hard.
You know?
And I would have to ask, you know, what's
You can
the
do it,
bend?
Though,
you
can't
need the
you?
Resistance
I know.
Because
you swing from trees when you're out in the wild. Yeah.
Well, I do pull-ups sometimes when I'm out in the wild,
yeah.
but I don't necessarily swing from trees, although that is fun.
Okay.
Tarzan.
But, yeah, it's... It's you got to ask yourself when you're going to do that. The most beneficial exercises to me are what match the seven general movement patterns, right? There's
mm-hmm.
flexion, extension, rotation. What are the other ones? Squat and then walking.
Mm-hmm.
Was that all of them? Lateral flexion, rotation, push, pull, flexion, extension. So if you're doing a movement that has some of those in it, it's going to be a beneficial movement. You just need to make sure it's safe for you.
Dr. Church, do you want to say anything?
No, that's spot on. I tell people, you know, it's so funny. So much what he said wouldn't make any sense to someone young.
Mm-hmm.
As you get older and you start losing these things because
mm-hmm.
we sit down all day,
right.
you accumulate the badness. It's all about function. And everything Daniel described was promoting function.
Yeah.
Yes.
Daniel, you're hired.
So great to have everyone in studio. Dr. Church, thank you so much for coming in studio today. Really appreciate it. It was an honor. Thank you so much.
Really enjoyed it. Thank you.
We did too. We really did. Everyone, I hope you enjoyed the show. We always enjoy doing it. Daniel, Elizabeth, thank you for being in studio as well. And everyone, thanks again for listening. You know what? You get one body, you get one mind, and you get one life. Get out there today and make the most of it.